Well, I'm ready to answer the next 10 questions out of Carl Shoup's book, Test Your Bible Knowledge. 9 of these questions will wrap up the book of Deuteronomy, and then the 10th question will be from the book of Joshua. The book of Deuteronomy has always been to me a summary of the books that came before it. And in this last part of the book of Deuteronomy, I'm pretty sure we're going to learn more about Joshua. We'll probably get an introduction to Joshua. And I always remember the saying, "Be strong and of good courage," being repeated over and over as he tried to encourage the Israelites as they went in to take the promised land. So in this next set of 10 questions, I imagine there'll be some questions regarding prophecy. I seem to remember that the Lord gives some warnings to Moses about what will most likely happen once the children of Israel get into the promised land. There are tribes in the promised land, and they don't worship the one true God. And they're probably going to be warned to stay away from those people. But the children of Israel, they'll intermingle and intermarry with those people, and there will be problems in the future. But this next set of 10 multiple choice questions, they're going to wrap up Deuteronomy. There'll be 4 answer choices, and one of those choices is the best answer, the correct answer, and it's my job to pick that one. So I am ready to answer those questions, and the first one is question number 231. The Lord did not promise, if the Israelites hearkened unto his voice and did all his commandments, that they would A, live to a ripe old age, B, lend to many nations but not borrow, C, find all the people of the earth afraid of them, D, be above only. Okay, so this question here, the Lord did not promise if the Israelites hearkened unto his voice and did all his commandments that they would. So we're looking for one that was not a promise. And I believe live to a ripe old age, that was a promise. And lend to many nations but not borrow, that again was a promise. Find all the people of the earth afraid of them, I believe that that was a promise also. And D is the mystery one, be above only. And I think that's the one I'm going to pick for this answer here. So 231, letter D. 232, and if they did not hearken to his voice and do all his commandments and statutes, the Lord did not promise that A, the heaven over their heads would be brass and the earth under them iron, B, he would smite them with a consumption, a fever and inflammation and extreme burning, the sword, blasting and mildew, C, they would lose their hearing and sense of smell, or D, they would go out one way against their enemies and flee before them 7 ways. Well, the only one that kind of sticks out here is C. They would lose their hearing and sense of smell. I'm going to pick C for the answer for this question here. 233. He further, in that event, did not promise that A, he would smite them with the botch of Egypt, the emrods, the scab, and the itch, B, their oxen would be slain before their eyes and they would not eat of it, C, all the males would become impotent, D, the stranger among them would lend to them and they would not lend to him. Here again, C kind of sticks out, all the males would become impotent. That seems like that would be the answer. These questions that are asked in a strange way where we're supposed to find out what was not promised. This is if the children of Israel didn't hearken to his voice, then a lot of things would happen to them, calamities and disasters and such. And we're supposed to pick out the one that's not one of those disastrous events. And I'm going to go with C for 233, and I want to stick with that one. Okay, 234. And finally, he did not promise that, okay, A, they would eat the flesh of their sons and daughters. B, the tender and delicate man would refuse to give his starving wife any of the flesh of their children that he would be eating. C, they would be sold to their enemies as bondmen and bondwomen, but no man would buy them. And D, they would give birth to children physically deformed and mentally retarded. All right, this one is a strange one here. I know, A, it was a promise that they would eat the flesh of their sons and daughters, and that actually did happen. It happens further on in the Old Testament. And B, the tender and delicate man, I don't think that that's correct. I think it's the tender and delicate woman would refuse to give his starving wife. I'm not sure about B, so B seems to be the one that I want to pick for the answer. C, they would be sold to their enemies. I believe that that was a promise. D, they would give birth to children physically deformed and mentally retarded. And I don't really remember reading about that either, so it's either B or D on this one. And I think this time I'm going to go ahead and go with D. They would give birth to those children. So I'm going to pick D, and we'll see what the correct answer is. Number 235. Shortly before Moses' death, the Lord predicted that his people afterward would A, desert the Lord and thereupon be devoured, B, faithfully worship the Lord and thereby prosper, C, split into two groups, one of A and the other of B, and D, prove unpredictable. Okay, this one is another strange question. Shortly before Moses' death, the Lord predicted that his people afterward would desert the Lord and thereupon be devoured. I'm not certain that is that happened. B, faithfully worship the Lord and thereby prosper. I don't think that that happened either. C, split into two groups, one of A and B of the above, or D, prove unpredictable. So I am going to have to guess here, because I do not know the answer for this one. Let's see, desert the Lord and thereupon be devoured. That seems to be like that would be the correct answer, because I know eventually that does happen. So for 235, I'm going to go ahead and go with A for my answer. 236. In the song that Moses wrote, the apple of his eye refers to the eye of A, Moses, B, the Lord, C, the Israelite nation collectively, or D, no one in particular. Let's see. I think that the answer here is A. In the song that Moses wrote, the apple of his eye refers to the eye of Moses, the Lord. Oh, goodness. Let's see. Maybe it is B, the eye of the Lord, the apple of his eye. I'm going to go ahead and change it up and put B down for 236 as my answer. 237. In To Me Belongeth Vengeance, me refers to A, the Lord, B, Moses, C, Joshua, or D, the Hittite king. Well, it's not D and it's not C. I am pretty sure it's A, the Lord. So 237, I'm answering letter A. 238. Moses saw the promised land from the mountain on which he died, and it's A, Mount Hor, B, Mount Sinai, C, Mount Nebo, or D, Mount Paran. And it is C, Mount Nebo, 238C. 239, the last question in the book of Deuteronomy. Moses lived, A, more than twice as long as Adam, B, half as long as Adam, C, less than 1/7 as long as Adam, or D, an unstated number of years. Okay, tricky question here. You're going to have to know how long Adam lived, and I don't recall how long Adam lived. D is not the answer, though, because it is stated in there. I remember it's 120 years. So the trick here, is that more than twice as long as Adam? I don't think so. So A and D are eliminated. B, half as long as Adam. Gosh, I think that Adam lived way more than 240 years. So I'm going to go with C by default, and we'll have to find out what the correct answer is. Okay, question number 240. It is the first question out of the book of Joshua, and it asks, the line of scarlet thread bound in the harlot Rahab's window in Jericho was A, a sign to clients, B, a safeguard against slaughter, C, a signal to attack, or D, an inconsequential decoration. Okay, I believe that the answer here is B, a safeguard against slaughter. 240, letter B. All right, and that makes 10 questions. Those were 10 kind of challenging questions, the information and the way that they were presented, and we'll see which ones I was able to answer correctly. So I'll go back here to where the answers are waiting for me, and I'll find number 231, and I put down D. Correct answer is A. So missed the very first one, so I'm going to look back here to 231. And it was, the Lord did not promise, if the Israelites hearkened unto his voice and did all his commandments, that they would, A, live to a ripe old age. Okay, that was what he did not promise. And I put D, be above only. So I missed that one. 232, correct answer is C, and I put C. 233 is C, and I put C also. 234 is D, and that's what I marked. 235 is A, I put down A. 236 is B, that's what I answered. 237 is A, and I got that one right. 238 is C, I have that one as C also. 239 is C, and I marked C for that one. 240 is B. Okay, that makes 1 out of 10. I got 9 right and I missed 1, so that is not too bad, especially with the way those questions were written. So it is off to the book of Joshua for the next 10 questions, and the Israelites will enter the promised land, and we'll learn more about the Israelites and what they encounter when they enter the promised land.